to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good evening. Dear Lord, we ask for your blessing and for your guidance as we make our way into the future with our new accomplishments. We ask you for your special prayers for our sons and daughters overseas, ensuring our freedom. Lord, hear our prayer.
Graduation candidates, we are proud of your accomplishments. You have made many sacrifices while you were in school, and you now serve as a wonderful role model for others in your life who may have been hesitant to further their education. I would like to extend a sincere thank you to our guests and that have provided a strong support system to our graduates. Without you, reaching this goal would have been much more difficult or perhaps impossible. I'd like to take a minute to recognize the individuals on the stand. Our first gentleman will be introduced to you in a few moments. Second, we have Marcellus Davis, our Director of Recruitment. Isabel Resendez, our Registrar. Lacey Tumuski, our Director of Finance. Stacia Norman, Director of Career Services. Mortimer Ennis, our Associate Dean. Ms. Tracy Blackman, one of our Drafting and Design Instructors. Jared Chapman, School Chair for Drafting and Design. Mr. Ali Dayu, Chair of Information Technology. And Mr. Hamid Wahidi, our Dean. And you may be seated. Thank you. Candidates, you leave ITT with a set of fundamental skills that you must continue to develop. You are educated and persistent, as evident by the diploma that you'll be receiving tonight. But never forget that learning should be considered a lifelong process. Your success in your career, as in most aspects of your life, is going to be dependent on you. And one of my favorite quotes comes from Colin Powell, who said, "There are no secrets to success. It is the result of preparation, hard work, and learning from failure." This is a continuous process, and the key for all of you is not to give up if you face disappointments. We encourage you to stay in touch. We want to know how you're doing, how you've been successful, how we can further assist you if you need to still continue to reach goals. It helps us stay passionate about what we do to hear how great you're doing and how much you love your job. And we're so proud for everything that you've achieved, everything you may have had to overcome to accomplish this, and the limitless things you can still do in your future. I'd now like to bring Ms. Stacia Norman to the podium, and she will introduce the guest speaker for this evening.
I would like to introduce Rory Laney. He is the founder and owner of Innovative Success Methods. As a motivational speaker and network marketing professional, his companies help small to medium-sized businesses on sales coaching and leadership development. Originally from Huntington, West Virginia, he enlisted in the Air Force immediately after high school. He retired from the Air Force after 23 years, serving the last 15 in recruiting. The pinnacle of his recruiting career was serving as an executive director of Air Force Recruiting for Colorado Springs, Colorado, where he was responsible for the overall operations of the largest recruiting team in the country. He provided leadership for over 125 recruiters, covering 8 states. Throughout his recruiting career, he affected the recruitment of over 50,000 young men and women to serve our country. He was regarded as one of the premier keynote speakers of our country. Since retiring from the Air Force and entering the private sector, Rory has utilized his extensive leadership and sales experience in career college industry. He has served as a director of admissions at 4 colleges, regional director of admissions, and a college president before starting his own company. Please join me in welcoming Rory Laney.
Well, good evening. Who's excited tonight? I
know this crowd over here to my right, they're pretty excited tonight, aren't you? Are you excited? Well, let me ask you this. Did you make this journey alone tonight?
No.
There were some folks that helped you, weren't they?
Yeah.
How about this? Stand up and give those folks a round of applause for helping you get here tonight. And for all you folks here tonight supporting the graduates, I know you're excited as well, aren't you?
Yeah.
Excited to see them graduate? Yeah. Excited to see them get out of the house? All right? How about you stand up and give them a round of applause for this accomplishment? Well, I'm excited to be here tonight. And let me just mention, that is the first time in my public speaking career I got two standing ovations before I ever started my speech. So I want to thank you all for that. But I'm excited about being here tonight. And before I get started, I would like to put a little disclaimer out. Two things I want to put a disclaimer on. First of all, if you are recording this using any of those fancy devices, cameras, iPads, iPhones, IHOPs, any of those things, I am not responsible for the damage caused by the reflection of my head to your recording device. So don't come up to me afterwards and say, Rory, you owe me for this iPad because you broke it, all right? Get that out there. Second thing, if you're recording this tonight and you decide that, hey, that was pretty good, let me put it on YouTube, please make sure you spell my name right, R-O-R-Y-L-A-N-E-Y. Those are my disclaimers. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm excited about being here tonight. This is indeed a special night, and some of you might know I have a tremendous amount of pressure on me tonight. Some of you in the audience knows what that pressure is, and some of the folks sitting up here knows what that pressure is. And I have to deliver the public speech, or the best speech of my public speaking career tonight. If I don't do it, I'll let you know later about the outcome, okay? So I'm going to do my very best for the graduates tonight. But I learned a long time ago in public speaking, there are three S's in public speaking. You stand up, you speak up, and then you shut up. So I hope to accomplish that tonight. But I'd like to take you back a few years ago when I was in Air Force recruiting, and I started out in a small town in eastern Kentucky doing recruiting for the Air Force. And my first public speech I ever gave was to the state convention of VFWs, and I got asked to deliver a speech. And I can remember just how nervous I was getting up in front of all these veterans and giving a speech. By the way, let me just stop here for just a second. Any veterans tonight, graduating tonight, veterans, please give them a round of applause. Thank you for all you've done for our country. But I got up to give a speech, and I can remember preparing for it. And folks, I got up there to speak that night, and I mean to tell you, I had a stack of 3x5 cards about this thick. I wasn't going to miss a beat. I mean, I was going to nail this speech. And I got up there, and I invited my boss to come down and watch, because I wanted to be proud of me. So he came down and was in the crowd, and he was watching. And I gave this speech. And about 45 minutes later, I said, thank you, ladies and gentlemen. And I mean, I got a standing ovation. And I was so proud. And I walked back and I looked at my boss and said, wow, they really like that. He said, no, they're just glad you shut up. So tonight, I'd like to do something different. Something a little bit different to the graduates tonight. First of all, congratulations on what you've accomplished. You got here by doing something different. And extraordinary people do different things. Think about that. Extraordinary people do different things. They think differently, they act differently, and they accomplish different things. So I want to challenge you tonight, as you walk across stage, get that degree, and you go out there and start the next chapter of your life, realize it's just that. The very next chapter. You have a blank canvas in front of you, and now it's up to you to put the artwork on it for the rest of the world to see. Typically, when I stand in front of crowds, I mention I don't know why I do, but I do, always mention about being raised poor in the hills of West Virginia. I'm not going to mention that tonight because it really doesn't matter. But I remember being raised poor in the hills of West Virginia. In fact, folks, we were so poor, I've had people ask me, how poor were you? We were so poor that the poor people used to look at us and say, oh, look at those poor people. Now that's poor. In fact, we were poor. P-O? We were so poor we couldn't afford the O&R. But I knew growing up I didn't want to continue being poor. And I knew that in order to get somewhere different, I had to do something different. And for me, the answer was because my folks were, actually I wasn't poor, it was just my folks, they took me along for the ride. I knew I couldn't get anywhere different unless I tried something different, I did something different, I thought differently. So I joined the Air Force to get my education. I still remember my mom standing at the Greyhound bus station when I shipped out, standing there saying, crying and saying, oh, my baby's going to war, he'll never be back. And my dad shaking my hand saying, son, go do 4 years, get your education and come back here. Well, 23 years later, after I thought about making a career out of it, I retired. It was that good to me. But see, I thought about doing something different. I knew to break the cycle of poverty that my family was in, I had to do something different. I had to think different. And each of you sitting here tonight, you had to think different to get where you're at tonight. Think about it. Before you walked in the very first time at ITT Tech to talk to that admissions representative, you thought differently, didn't you? You said to yourself, I want to do something different with my life. I want to change my career. I want to go a different direction. And so you started thinking differently. And when I think about the words think different, I can't help but think of the man that created a device that most of us are carrying with us tonight. Steve Jobs, the founder of Apple, right? And many of us have him with us tonight. Can I see him? Everybody put him up, don't we? Everybody has one, right? But Steve Jobs said, he challenged his people that worked for him in that garage in California before he built one of the largest companies in the world. He challenged them to think different. Think different. And so tonight, graduates, I say to you, think different. Continue to think different. Because by thinking differently, you will get somewhere different in life. And then once you start thinking different, put some actions to it. Put some actions to it and do something different. And when I think about milestones in life that things are done differently, I can't help but think about this. I think back to an event, a milestone that people thought would never be broken. And if you follow sports and athletics, there was a milestone that people thought for years and years would never be broken. And that milestone was the 4-minute mile. People used to think there's no way humanly possible that a human being can run a mile in less than 4 minutes. It's just not possible. But in 1954, an Englishman by the name of Bannister broke the 4-minute mile in 3 minutes, 58 seconds. He broke it. What did that mean? He did something differently, right? He did it different. And ladies and gentlemen, you know what's amazing? Is that since he proved it was different, he proved it was possible, right? He proved it was possible. Say it with me. It's possible.
It's possible.
I can't hear you.
It's possible.
I can't hear you.
It's possible.
It's possible. Because I'll tell you, when you walked in ITT Tech, there were a lot of people saying, no, never make it. But you're here tonight. Why? It's possible. Right? But since he broke the 4-minute mile, it's amazing to find out that the 4-minute mile has been broken over 250 times. Why? Is possible, right? In fact, 10 years later, a young man at a high school in Oklahoma, any Okies in the house?
Yeah.
All right, not very many. Okay, never mind. Young man at a high school in Oklahoma in 1964, as a high school junior, Jim Ryan broke that previous record and ran the mile in 3 minutes and 54 seconds. breaking the all-time record of anyone prior to college. Why? It's possible, right? So it's possible for you to go out tonight after tonight and go paint that canvas and make it anything that you want it to be. You can become anything that you want to be. In fact, ladies and gentlemen, if you would have told me that 35 years ago plus, that I would be standing in front of a crowd delivering a speech at a commencement exercise in Houston, Texas, I would have said it's not possible. I could have never done it. But things are possible. Yes. Even a poor kid from the hills of West Virginia can live his dream and do what he wants to do. So I challenge you to go and do what you want to do. Because as I found is this, ladies and gentlemen, if you truly love what you do, you'll never work a day in your life. If you truly love what you do, it's your passion to do what you do, you'll never work a day in your life. And in closing, I don't want to mess this up. In closing, my challenge is this, that each of you go, find your passion in life. Whatever that passion is, find it, chase it, and paint your own masterpiece of success. May God bless each of you. Thank you.
Mr. Rahigi to present the Dean's Award.
Good evening. Dean's Award selected by faculty and staff at ITT based on academic achievement, conduct, and attendance. And almost all of these, actually all of them, are highest honors, which that's the GPA between 3.8 and 4.0. For the School of Business, Associate of Applied Science, Marcus C. Brown. School of Criminal Justice, paralegal, Tara Villarreal. School of Drafting and Design Technology, Associate of Applied Science, John Mooney. School of Electronic Technology, Bachelor of Science, Aura Morales. School of Electronic Technology, Associate of Applied Science, Alexander Petno. Information Technology, Bachelor of Science, William S. Childress. School of Information Technology, Bachelor of Science, Project Management and Administration, Jonathan D. Thomas. Information Technology, Associate of Applied Science, Ann Walls. Congratulations. At this time, I'd like to ask Mr. Mortimer Innes to come forward for certification of business and paralegal.
Thank you, Dean Marghighi. Before I begin, if you would turn your attention to the table on your right, my left, you'll notice the roses. Each candidate, as they come up, will grab a rose, and they're going to give that to that significant person who kept them motivated to keep going to reach this day, because we all know it takes a lot of dedication from a lot of different people. So, kind of your way to show that motivation and appreciation. At this time, I have the honor to present the candidates for the School of Business Bachelor of Science degree in Project Management and Administration. The candidates would please stand and come forward. Robert Beavers Otters. Brenda L. Citizen. Frederick Henson, honors. Amanda M. Langendorf, highest honors. James McDonald, honors. Alejandro Meza. Robert L. Parsons. Hector Reyes. Tomas Sacido, honors. Shannon Smith. Jonathan D. Thomas, highest honor, perfect attendance. At this time, I have the honor to present the candidate for the Associate of Applied Science in the School of Business, Business Management, Marcus C. Brown. And I also have the honor to present the candidate for the School of Criminal Justice, Associate of Applied Science and Paralegal. The candidate will please come forward. Kimberly Russell. At this time, I would like to call the chair for the School of Drafting and Design Technology, Mr. Chapman.
Hello, my name is Jerry Chapman. How are you doing this evening? I'm the Draft and Design Chair. Tracy Blackman is helping me. She is a great mentor to our program and been with us for a long time as well. If you have me in class, I'm kind of a nerd, all right? And there's a lot of power for nerds.
Yes.
All right? We're in tech school, so embrace the nerd inside of you. Nerds make money. I do one-on-ones with my students, and I'll say, come on up. I need to talk to you one-on-one. And this has been a great class, and it is my honor for the last time to say to this drafting and design crew, come on up. This has been a great group. While they're walking, I'm going to talk about them. So this has been an exceptional group. You know, the power of our classroom or of a group or business leaders depends on the group. So some atoms are stronger than others. Their positive and negative charges are stronger. But the protons and neutrons of this group, it's unbelievable. All right. This is for the School of Drafting and Design Technology, Associates of Applied Science. Drafting and Design Technology. ADDA, Marcel Barnes. ADDA, Andrew Guerrero. Highest honors, ADDA, Kevin Hall. ADDA, Ramoris Johnson. Honors, ADDA, William Lott. Highest honors, ADDA, John J. Mooney. ADDA, Juan Perez. ADDA, ADBA, Danita Robinson. I bring forth Dean Rahigi to announce the electronic students.
President, I have the honor to present the candidates for the Bachelor of Science in Electrical Engineering and Communication Technology. Candidates, please come forward. Highest honors, perfect attendance, Chris Caballero. Highest honors, perfect attendance, Christopher Carrizales. Highest honors, Stephen Cousin. Honors, perfect attendance, John Garcia. Honors, perfect attendance, Miller E. Johnson. Highest honors, perfect attendance, ETA, NTHS, which is National Technical Honor Society, Aura Morales. Congratulations.
Ms. Burton, I also have the honor to present the candidates for the School of Electronic Technology, Associate of Applied Science. Trey Barfield. Ivan Barrientos. Mariano Barrientos. Highest honors, member of ETA, AITP, and National Technical Honor Society, Batema, Alexander Batema. James Edwards. Honors, ETA, FLBA, AITP, and National Technical Honor Society, Jose Ipkiss. Thomas Johnson, ETA. Alan Leo. Georgiana McCall. Lester Perry. DeMarcus T. Price. Lawrence Tillman. Gregory Ward. Highest honor, ETA, FBLA, AITP, and National Technical Honor Society, Jasmine Williams. Mitchell Young. Muhammad Zaman. Chair of Information Technology. Ms. Alina, you can come forward for certification of School of Information Technology.
Thank you, Mr. Rahim. Good evening.
Good evening.
It is my pleasure to present to you the candidates for the Associate of Applied Science degree in Computer and Network System Administration. Candidate, please stand and come forward. I.T.T member Troy Taylor. Member Luana Williams. Congratulations to all the graduates. At this time, congratulations.
hereby confer upon you the degrees and diplomas you have earned, together with all appropriate honors, privileges, and responsibilities thereof. Graduates, you may move your tassels. Guests, I would like to thank all of you for attending this evening. Please remain seated until the stage and the graduates have exited the auditorium. Thank you.